Okay, so it's Sunday morning, last day of training. I didn't bring the cameras yesterday, just gonna do all the filming today. It was a pretty busy day yesterday, I'm pretty tired. It was a good day, learned a lot. I mean, firefighting and road rescue is just like, you know, because sometimes you come up on a vehicle and just, you know, they don't wreck all the same way every time when you're having a front-end collision, you know, so. But what a great training session here in Kelowna. Great bunch of guys, Kelowna Fire Department, and learning a lot. So we'll have the camera today on the helmet, and I'll have another camera in my pocket. So when I get a chance to, I'll do some video. So hopefully it all turns out. Peace to you and yours. Yeah, we tore this one apart yesterday. It had doors yesterday.
Down here on the dirty side, that's not really a big issue. We have purchase points everywhere, right? Is there another one on the other side? But over here on the sandy side, if you come over here, that could be an issue. So this is where creativity comes in, and we'll show you some things with normal struts for stabilization that you can do. But there are strut manufacturers that are changing things up, and we've designed a new way to do it. And this is a class of strut called a prop strut. So you get lifting struts, prop struts. And the difference here, somebody tied that off. So what's nice about these a little bit, you can throw them over your shoulder like a shoulder strap type thing. These are more made for engines now because they don't have the long extension, but they're fast. Lots of slack. And you're ready to go. And it's that quick. But you'll notice something here that's different from the straps you're used to. That is, it's attached here to the head, right? So what you can do now, take a little slack, go around to the dirty side, so what Sean just did there, well, just go to pull. He uncoupled the base plate, or the head, and he turned that back into a lifting strut. Go ahead, pull. So what's cool about this is, tight, ready? Now watch the head of that strut over there. I can't see it. What's going on? Oh, I didn't tighten it off enough? So because the head is restrained by the strap, it can't go up anymore. So all the force now, you see how buckled this in? Is just pushing straight into the vehicle, but we didn't have to get a purchase point. So for a vehicle on the side that you're not going to have to lift, which is 99.9 of them, right? This is a single firefighter operation in about 30 seconds in stabilization.
Yeah. So one of the little tricks for you guys that have struts already, are you going to get them, is a lot of times when you get a car on its side, the hood or the trunk gets displaced upward by force. And so what you end up is you get the corner panels like this, and the trunk is like this, and it's above the corner panel, and it's sealing off the seams up here, right? And you go in here to get your strut head in there somewhere, you just can't get it in there because you're blocked. It's one of those stupid things, we just don't think this way, but if you just lift the strut, change the angle, and then drop it, you'll actually go in there and then pry that hood or trunk back down to get your purchase point. So a simple little, oh yeah, I never thought about lifting the whole strut up, and then I can get a better angle into there. Once again, what I was talking about, and you're engaged.
A different spot, like maybe put it here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Move all the way up. start with the blue all the way out.
Start with the blue all the way out?
Yeah, you need to coordinate your side with the other side. So in this case, the best thing to do right here is not even use or what you can do is this. Check this out. Pull that.
Sean, how far, like, what's our,
your angles with 42s are between 45 yeah, and 70 degrees.
Okay, 45 and
70. Well within that.
Okay.
Yellow pin. There we go.
Need a yellow pin, yeah.
Okay, you gotta get it in.
Right there.
There you go.
Put it in the hole.
There you go.
Gotta find the hole.
Now, this one's got its own attached strap over here. You might as well use it. Just clip that right to the base plate. There you go. Make sure that foot points right at this one. Slide the base plate to the right. No, that's your left. To your right. Go, one more. There we go. Yep. Okay, now, watch what you're doing. Give it one more crank and watch what he does to the car. Go ahead. What did he just do?
Lift it up?
He's lifting the car.
That's too much?
That's right there, so okay. Don't go any further. You're lifting the car where you are. So not only is it stable, but now if you had to lift to get like a handout.
So you guys did it on now, okay.
Yeah, I did his trick. Just and came in, went right in.
Yep. So that quick. So these can be both used as lifting struts, like a standard, or as a prop strut, which would be used if you didn't have a purchase point.
The entire strut's probably only steel is some base plates and a couple pins. But we'll get into these a little bit more. Tim will show a little demo with the lifting round that goes on top. Cool. Okay guys, let's come up to the front of the car. Let's talk about what we got on the go. These neat little spots in the car we can go off of. Rather than trying to bust this window and get a hook around the seat post, maybe we're gonna cut this seat post where we want our strap sliding off or being in the way. You can go at other things, seat belts, and connection points for car seats. I use those all the time and guys are like, what are you doing? I'm like, it's rated. I've lifted the entire vehicle up by a seatbelt with a forklift and it will not break. It's tough as nails. By all means, it's going to be enough strength to hold our strap in place for a strut.
So that will be tight. Ready to go?
Yeah, you have to suck yours up for that. You ready?
Left in the car, you guys see it going up? Okay. But now look, we've left the people tank open. Okay. And because it's chain, it doesn't matter whether we've got a good purchase point or whatever. The chain just gets everything.
Whoever's grabbing the spreader there, just drop that in right here and here. We're gonna count the wins. I like to count the wins in my maneuvers because A, I'm a lazy human being. B, it's more efficient.
What is this going to do for me, okay? As I spread this out, my door's going down and away from my patient, okay? So that's a win right there. I've got a little bit more room here for me to, you know, get more hard protection in, whatever, have an assessment on that patient. The next added benefit, what's going to happen here, I'm going to actually start opening up purchase points for myself, okay? Front and back, you guys saw this over there. What you're doing is gaining access to be able to get your sawzall or your air chisel in there to get your hinges. We're kind of doing the same thing, just a little bit different, I guess. So go ahead and, with the handle towards you, if you can drop that sprinter tip in right here. Once you get it up there, okay, go ahead and start opening it up. Okay, and drop it in. Go ahead and
ride that out a little bit?
Yep.
Keep going. Something that happened the second that hinge pops, you stop. Okay, and it's human nature. The second we feel as if we've achieved a goal, we stop and we reset. That's immediately what we want to do. If you have a good footprint, a good bite, the mentality of the sprinter person needs to be you're making room for your cart. That's your gig. Okay. So what is the downside to keeping on going here? As long as you got a good bite and you're not going to blow your spread. There's no downside. You'll probably blow your strap. There's potential that you'll take your second hinge, right? So these are all potential wins, as well as making space. He doesn't have the space here. And this is where we changed the mentality in last scenario, where we're working cutter, spreader, combo. That person with the cutter is sitting there frothing at the mouth at any opportunity to cut anything. That guy. Okay. So you're reading in here, and it's two things. Number one, it's a second set of eyes, right? You're getting ready because her job is literally to make you room for that hinge. Okay. So go ahead and run that out, and we'll see what we can get out of this. Okay, so you're going to position yourself over here and you're going to leave your spinner in place for two reasons. Number one, if he needs a bit more room,
you've got it.
I don't have to go back in there and grab it. Number two, if I let go of this spread, my door's coming back, right? So as soon as, here's the issue with this. What are we introducing into this door right now with that tool? A lot of pressure, right? So if he goes ahead and cuts that, what did I tell you before about don't stand in front of it, right?
Yeah.
So your job is to stand here. He's going to get a good bite and say, okay, I'm good, right? And if you want to make yourself look really peachy, grab your strap, your cables, and your hinge at the same time.
Right over top. There you go.
I got a good bite.
Now you can back your spreader up. So, I've done my job with my spreader, so I set it down and then I'm going to watch this guy.
Go!
You do it all the time. I have a job. So, you're going to set your spreaders in here and open up this window well.
Do you want me to keep cutting?
head over there.
And watch what she's doing. Something's gonna happen. If she gets engaged on this nader pin and it starts skinning, he's got work to do, right? So he's already ready with his jaws open. So jaws open versus jaws closed stored. That's 10 seconds, 5 seconds, right? If I have to stand there, oh, hang on, guys, right? I'm not doing my job, okay? So go ahead.
I guess I don't need to cut.
No, not this time, but you're prepared, right?
Yep, yep.
Okay.
Good job.
Can you guys see you go back in the municipality, work with some guys that you work with, you're comfortable with the tools, how quickly that can happen, right? Top pinch, blow them, spread that out, grab a bite, go back to your nader, engage, the cut is done, blow your nader pin on. Doors fall off in a big hurry.
Okay, start on. So remember we were talking about big footprint?
Yep.
Big footprint.
Especially with the chew orientation, because it's so high like that. Put the handle the other way around and lock your elbow.
Talk about some stuff. We'll all agree that what we do for a job is that we mitigate risks and we do dangerous shit, right? We do dangerous shit the safest way possible. We are going to load this car up. That is a fact of life.
Here we go. Ready?
What did we get?
About 3 inches of that strap, so there's probably more here.
Thank you.
that in that backside to help that cut around.
Okay, so I'm going to put these in this.
So this, guys, is where you're going to want to chase this in. See where we're hanging up here?
You want to do that little flip there?
There it is. Right,
yeah, so I should go down deeper into this.
You should drop right in there, you bet you can.
Down in
here. Guard.
Okay, so it's been a really couple good days of training. We're in the afternoon. Hopefully you enjoyed some of that shit this morning. I'm gonna go see if I can see anything, see any tools, film some junk, see how it goes. So there's all the toys we've been playing with. You can see, like, you know, just different rams, spreaders, cutters, multi-tools here. So obviously these two would be the cutters. A spreader, the ram. That one's a multi-tool, because you can spread, and you can see in the middle there, it's got like the cable cutter part of it as well, so you can shear in the middle as well, like a scissor, right? Yeah, that's what we've done. There's nothing more fun than cutting cars to pieces, unless you blow them up. So, anyway, onward and upward.
Supposed to be
breaking glass.
Yeah, but
you want to break this one too?
I was waiting for that to kick in. I heard what you were saying.
Breaking glass.
I'll nibble at this a bit.
What do you want it? Oh.
That goes though, into that wrap all the way into this frame up here. By your hands, cut. That metal. Wrap all the way up by your.
So if we go in here with the bombing tool, stuff that right in there, and spread that.
Okay, so we got a couple options for moving that seat back. We assume that.
Can we just, how about if we use the ram and just kind of try to break the mechanism?
So push it from off here, you mean?
Back. Yeah, yeah, push one side.
Go on that side right there. And if you push off to there,
snap the pins.
The bottom of the seat. Yep, and then lay the ram over. And get straight and retract it.
Straighten it up.
Like that?
This way,
nope.
This way.
No, no, this like.
Straight. Oh, like that, like down. Straight. Okay.
Same thing, just like.
Combi tool is nicer because you've got that smaller insertion.
I don't think I got it all the way through.
A little bit more, push it again.
A little more?
A little more, yeah. There you go, there you go. You got it.
No. So now that
it's just like the
that,
it's
right?
Just the material now on this side.
More struts?
Instead of basically instead of trunk tunneling, your car's cut down. We're just going to craft jag and expose the full back. So as you guys see it, you'll see how
Okay. Gary, we'll let these guys do what they're doing, and then we'll talk about it after they're done.
Okay.
Thank you.
got two people mining these ratchet straps.
How's it going?
Keep going, tighten it up, guys. You want to keep going?
Cut there. Same on the other side. Chain in the middle, two straps. Okay, so we're all done in Kelowna. It was an absolute fabulous weekend. Learned a lot. Okay, you can't see my face because I'm in the sun. Okay, you can see me now. I have so much in my brain right now, I can't even make heads or tails of it. I got to decompress and process all this information that I just came upon. But if you can volunteer, if you have the wherewithal or the ability or the time or whatever to volunteer firefighter to help your community out, I highly recommend it. You're going to meet a whole bunch of great people who just want to help, just want to do good and help others, right? Just, you know, it could be your mom or your sister in a car all wrecked up, and you want to know that there's dudes there, women there that are going to take care of this stuff, right? So, awesome bunch of people, awesome crew here in Kelowna Fire, did a great job, and had a good time. So, peace to you and yours, hope to see you on the flip side.